Hi, this is Michelle Yurovsky, Product Lead for Analytics at UiPath. Today, I'll be giving you a quick overview of how to use custom fields from Robot Logs and Queues in Insights, our RPA Analytics product. So what you see right here is the My Dashboards tab of Insights. I've made a few copies of our templates. We'll actually be going straight to the configuration page so that you can get a head start into configuring custom variables. So keep in mind, the only way that you'll have access to this menu with all of these options is if you're an admin. So if you are not an admin, you'll only see the dashboards option. The specific menu item we're interested in is configure custom variables. So what you see here is a split between custom variables that come from processes and queues. And here we have limitations on the number of string, number, and date time fields you can configure per process and per queue. So for processes, you can configure up to 225 variables, and the same for queues, giving you a total of 450 potential variables at your disposal. Now, let's say we're interested in building a dashboard about the RPA challenge. We're going to search specifically for a process called RPA challenge. And you can see here, I've actually already selected a field I'm interested in, the speed that it took to complete the challenge. But let's say I'm interested in a few other things, potentially the browser type. So how I would extract this field is I would come to this browser type checkbox under the extract column and click it. Now I have this type option and I can decide if it's a string, meaning it's text, a number, something like 123, or a date time. This is specifically for dates in the date time format. This will make things much easier if you're interested in doing things like finding the time difference between two dates. Browser type is definitely going to be a string, so we'll select that. And lastly, I can mark this as common. So common means that this browser type variable is assumed to be present across multiple processes. So let's say I have a few other processes and I want to be able to build a dashboard referencing browser type across all of these processes. I would mark it as common. Because none of my other processes have browser type, we're going to leave it unchecked. And we can just hit save. Now when this is done, we'll be able to go back to our dashboards and check them out. So we'll go back to dashboards. We'll actually create a new dashboard called RPA Challenge. And we'll add a tile. And when you extract fields from your processes, you're going to find them under the Robot Logs Explorer. Because the way to log these custom fields and processes is in Robot Logs using the Add Log Fields activity in Studio. So you see we have quite a few fields here, and you can tell that a field was selected as common or not based on the way it displays. So for example, we have this insightsfeeder.activityinfo property. This is a custom field, and I can tell it's a custom field because it's named process name, which is insightsfeeder.property, which is activityinfo. And the fields that we selected from the RPA challenge will show up in the same format. So if we scroll down, here we are, RPA.challenge, which is the process name, .browserType, which is the field I extracted, and same with the speed, which was already extracted. If we had decided to mark this field as common, which again means that we think it's present in multiple processes and want to report across all of those processes, we would see something like this. Log F transaction ID. So this is a really common field in the RE framework, which is why it was extracted as a common variable. This is not part of the robot logs by default, but somebody went and extracted it. And because it does not have the process name in front of it, you know it was marked as common. Now, if we wanted to build a dashboard using the fields we extracted, we can just click on them. And let's just run this and we'll put this in a really simple table just so that you can have access to them. There you are. And let's say we wanted to maybe grab the number of jobs that this RPA challenge ran. So what we'll do is we'll go to successful jobs. And we're gonna wanna add a filter on the process name, which is equal to rpa.challenge, and run this. There we are. That's pretty much how you use custom fields. So let's take a look at a similar example for queues. So we'll go back and configure our custom variables. Now for queues, because you can store custom variables for queues in three specific places, just a reminder, that would be specific data when you're first adding a queue item, and also analytics data and output data when you finish processing the queue item. We'll split those for you in separate sections. Here we only have data for queues that have specific data, but output data and analytics data would appear just like this in a collapsible section if we detected any custom fields. So this works exactly the same way. Extract, pick a type, select common, and save. And the way to access anything you select from queues is if we go back to our dashboards, go straight back to our RPA challenge dashboard. Here, we're going to go to our queues explorer. And for example, here is a field that was extracted. So that's pretty much it. Custom fields can be used. You can also use them to enrich things like ROI dashboards to add some custom values that you might not have added in the ROI data set. So possibilities are endless. Thank you so much for watching. To learn more about UiPath Insights, check out the rest of our YouTube playlist, or you can visit us at uipath.com/insights. Thanks.